students. Hello students, today let us learn on opportunity cost. It is a widely used term in economics, the term opportunity cost. But I know all of us are very much familiar with the word opportunity, and we often use the word in our day-to-day life also. As you know, suppose for example, let me state an example, it will be clear to you. Say for 2 hours you are watching a movie on the TV, and at the same time there is been a cricket match of your two favorite clubs going on in the playground, and instead of going to the playground to watch the cricket match, you are watching the movie on the TV. Now one of your friend who had been in the cricket match might come to you and visit you and explain about the cricket match, and he might be telling you that since you were not in the match and you were in the movie, you lost the opportunity to see the match, which was so wonderful. So this is the term we always use in our life, in this way, in our day-to-day life. In economics also, we use this word opportunity cost almost in the same manner that I have given the example. Say, what does it mean then? Let us see. So, by the definition of opportunity cost, it means that the opportunity cost of any good is the next best alternative good that is sacrificed or forgone. What does it mean? Next best alternative good. As you know, the resources that we use to make any production or any consumption or whatever, these resources can be used for so many of different purposes. So the resources have different alternative uses. When we choose the resources for one particular purpose or for producing one particular good, we cannot produce some other good with these available resources, because once we have used in one purpose, we cannot use it for other purpose. So it is said that it is the foregone, the next best alternative good. So opportunity cost of any good is the next best alternative good that is sacrificed or foregone. How, why this happens? This is because the resources that we have are very scarce, are scarce in nature, and the ones are unlimited, and all the scarce resources have alternative uses. For example, we can say here, say a piece of wood. A piece of wood can be used to make a duster, make a table, make any other commodities or goods made up of wood. Now, once we decide to make a table with a piece of wood, we cannot use this piece of wood to make any other commodities made of wood. So it happens like this: everything needed cannot be produced at the same point of time. So opportunity cost is the next best alternative that is foregone. So production of a particular commodity involves sacrifice of another commodity which could have been produced by using same amount of resources. The loss of potential gain from other alternatives when one alternative is chosen. So here are some examples that will be very clear to you about this concept of opportunity cost. Suppose you have rupees 50 and you have decided to spend it on a textbook. Then the opportunity cost is the restaurant meal that you cannot afford to pay. Or another example you can see here, if you spend 2 hours studying economics in online mode, say today, then the opportunity cost is that you cannot have those hours for playing game on some nice mobile app games. Some more examples that you can see later on, it will be available with you. Thus, we can find the main and fundamental problem of economies is the issue of scarcity. Therefore, we are concerned with the optimal use and distribution of these scarce resources. Wherever there is scarcity, we are forced to make choices. So we have to make choices between two or more. So this is what is called opportunity.